Right, just posting up to the social media. I'll fix that audio issue. There we go. Okay. Now let's see. Are you guys getting double audio, or is that just me? Test the chat. Cool. Alrighty, well, says that no one's watching, but that's okay. I got my broken DSs today, and I got 9 of them. There's a whole pile over here. Dun, dun, dun. That's cool. And what I thought I'd do is just have a look at one that has a broken hinge. And because it's got a broken hinge, I don't think it's worth keeping the casing. So what I'm going to do is open it up, have a look inside, and see what parts we can just put into the parts bin to fix one of the other ones. The person I bought it from said that he has made no attempt to repair anything. And hopefully no one else has too. So let's get started, eh? Oh, got my new screwdriver. Fancy, fancy. Take the battery cover off first. Alrighty. So then, that was a Phillips. There's 2 more Phillips heads here under the battery. Actually, you know, I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's have a look at what happens first when we plug it in, huh? So it's got the broken hinge, so I fully expect the top screen may not be working. So we'll just turn it on. Oh, there we go. Yeah, so the cable in there is probably a bit stuffed. You can see it might, maybe you can see it on the camera. It's sort of flashing around. But touch screen seems to work. Sound, I can hear it. Screen's nice and bright. Alrighty. Let's continue taking it apart. You might notice I'm in my pajamas, stay at home and all that, but really, what happened is my boys are at daycare today and they're having a pajama party at daycare. So we actually took them into daycare with, okay, so that's the tri-wing one. We took them into daycare. And we all wore pajamas as we went in there. So all the kids were wearing pajamas and mum and dad are wearing pajamas. It was pretty cool. I see my hands are in the way when I do this. I don't know how we're going to work it out in the future. I've got some new cameras coming in eventually. But I have to rely on the postal service, of course, which is very, very slow at the moment. Okay, that's all the screws that I can see. But I do believe that there's some under this pad. Oh, there we go. Maybe if I use this side. No? How do I get this pad off? There we go. I really should just use this box, huh? Okay, so these are the outside screws. Oh yeah, and there's this tri-wing right here as well. There's that one. Take this pad out as well. One more screw here. Ah, so these ones are Phillips heads again, just to trick me. There's two types of screws, of course. Little Phillips heads. And a little tri-wing, I think it's called. Anyway, it's a three. It's got three edges instead of four. There we go. And these things are all those ones there for the top, for the outside cover. I'm going to take this out. Okay, so where does it come apart now? Oh, okay. Oh, something went crunch. What's this bit from? Maybe the volume slider? Oh, gosh. See, this is why I'm doing it on a broken one first. So these shoulder buttons, obviously very temperamental. Put him there. The button itself looks okay. Take this one off as well, just because we can. And this one stayed intact. I've got this cool little microscope over here. So let's just play with it, huh? That'll be cool. Alrighty. Ooh, so close. So close, let's go. Just a little less close. Wow, that's actually really good. Alrighty. Where's the little shoulder button? Is here. Look how small it is. It's so small. My fingernail doesn't even fit over it. Okay, there, and there's my big fat fingernail. Wow. I was actually really worried this microscope wouldn't put out a good picture, but actually it's really nice. There's the other one. we look in the pinholes? Oh, wow, that's cool. Hey, look, there's a bent one. A bent pin? Is it badly bent, though? I don't know. It's not in the same place as the rest of them, that's for sure. That's cool. What about this side? Can we look down in there? So this is the DS game slot cartridge, and the other bit was the advanced game slot cartridges pins. How you going, Daryl? Just taking apart a Nintendo DS. Because why not? So yeah, that's a pretty cool little microscope. Okay, now, how do we take the board off? I don't know. I think this comes off there. Oh, that's hard to pull off. There's a little antenna. Where's the microscope? I can show you again. The little antenna there. There it is. That tiny little thing goes on here. And, yeah, it actually was on with quite some force. And that goes in underneath this card port. This could take a while. Okay. I don't know how it fits under there. Does this card come off here? Yes. Yes, it does. Okay. I don't know what that is, but the fact that it has an antenna might be the Wi-Fi. I'm just trying to pull this little cable through. There we go. Because it's coming through the hinge that we have to get it all out of there. What else needs undoing? Well, here's something. Oh! That's another little antenna. I don't know what that goes to. So there's a screw here. Maybe that's all that's holding it on now. And that's a board level screw. All right, gentle, gentle. Ah, oh, there we go. And there's the screen. Let's bring trusty microscope back and have a look at this connector because my eyes just can't see it in the light I've got. I've got to get some more lights because, yes, this setup's too dark in the room. Alright, there it is there. So I think, was that pushed down or does it pull up? You'd think it pulls up, wouldn't you? Let's try something. A tool? No, no way. There we go. So it flicks up. And then we should be able to take this cable out. And there's a bottom screen. Where else is he connected? Back on the front of the board. Oh, wow. Okay. So right... Where am I? Right here is another connection. And it's so small, I didn't even see it. All right, have fun. Okay. There we go. That lifts up there. And I don't know how I'm going to get that back in later. There we go. And that's that one out. There's another connection over here. So this one will flick up again too. Yes. Ease it out. All right. We have the baseboard. There. The main logic board of the Nintendo DS here. Excellent. This one looks in pretty good condition. And like we saw when I tested it at the start, what small amount of testing I did, it's had pretty good components. So actually here is quite good. This is the water sensor, so indicator. It'll turn completely red if it gets too wet inside the DS. And that is perfectly dry, normal indication. So no water damage, which is fantastic. Alright, so we've got the main board, put that aside, and we also have, I don't know why I'm looking through the microscope still, here we go, we have the bottom screen, which has a very slight scratch on it, but the picture was really quite clear. I'll put that aside too. Let's keep going. Alright, I've got some button pads, which need a clean. It's pretty gross. Look. Yes, I'm sure they're all the same. Here's another one. Oh, no, this one's better. Oh, it's still gross. And start and select. Got these two little cables. So the white one is routed underneath everything in this channel. And then they all go through to the top. Well, there we go. Lost. Those were the buttons. Start and select. And we can push out all of these ones too. More buttons. And the D-pad. Excellent. We'll give all those things a clean. Spare buttons. Okay, there's two screws here. Maybe that's what holds the top on. It's also where the light is for the power indication. Put that one down there. Try not to mislabel my screws. These are huge, these ones. Okay. Yep. Okay. So that takes that edge off the hinge there. And then this, what do we do here? Slides out. How do we get? Oh, okay, so there's a little slit. There's a little slit in the plastic where you can put the ribbon cable in so that once everything's in place, you could just pull it out. That's pretty clever. I like that. So there's the front facing. That's nothing wrong with that. And so the problem with the hinge is here. That's a good way to show it. The plastic is cracked here, and it's not something that you can easily repair because of the, that's supposed to be all one piece covered around there. I wonder if I could 3D print a DS case that would be suitable just for using, not for selling, of course, but yeah, that would be interesting. Okay, so around this cable is a little metal ring. Let's see if I could just wind this cable up enough. Oh, it's fiddly. That the ring can come out. I might just leave it. Let's see what we can do. So I'm assuming that there's screws under these pads. Where did I put that? Let's see, what tools do I have? Maybe this one? If not, maybe the tweezers? Rubber thing here. Actually have no idea how to get into this top case. Aha! Yes. So there are little screws under there. There. Sneaky, sneaky. Not easy to peel out. There we go. Have to be unafraid to damage it. It's all right, it's already broken. There's another one here. There's four in total. There we go, getting the hang of it now. Yeah. Perfect. And it's a Phillips head. More Phillips. Okay, let's get this right. Top screen with the top blobs. Okay, just put my fingernail in there, or not there. Here. Still feels kind of jammed in there. What if this rubber comes out? Does. However, it didn't seem to help any. Well, I've got that little ring out. Okay. I think this would be where my heat gun would come in handy if I had one. Never mind. I mean, do I need to take that out? I don't know. It looks like there's glue in there, maybe. You can see where the ribbon cable is torn. Right there, where it bends. So I'm going to get a good view of that. Anyway, maybe you can see it there. My big fat hands. Here we go. In here. Definitely torn right there. So that's just over one of the tracks. Which is enough to make that screen pretty useless for longevity. Wouldn't trust it in anything else, that's for sure. Now, how do I get this thing open? Oh my goodness, that's cool. Okay, so here's me trying to pull at it, but if I slide it slightly. I got somewhere here. A little bit of a slide. First. And then. There we go. Oh, that was easy. Oh, I struggled for so long. Tape protecting the speaker cable. Yeah, this looks like the Wi-Fi in the top there. And I'll have to curl that to get it through again. I wonder if that would have been easier with the metal cylinder still in there or not. Man, that's hard. It would be so easy just to wreck that ribbon cable trying to put it back in. The speaker. The little O-ring thing there. Another one must be stuck on the speaker or still. Yes. Time to use a little bit of force. There we go. Top bits off. So this is just stuck on with glue. That's why it's so difficult. Oh, there we go. I mean, if it wasn't for that ribbon cable, it'd be a lovely screen. Oh, so there's the speakers stuck together there, but still. So the speakers are attached to the same cable as the screen. And the white cable that I didn't know what it was is the microphone. Which just pops right out. There we go. See how grotty that is. It doesn't really show up too well. But yeah, there's little bits of yuck in there. As you would expect. Alright, cool. So that's it. We've dismantled the first one. I think from there we've got speakers. Probably a microphone. Didn't get to test it really. A new Wi-Fi module. The Wi-Fi bit on the board. All the buttons, the main board, and the bottom screen, all good for another DS. You know, this top glass looks quite nice. Maybe I could peel that off, I don't know. I'll keep it in the parts bin anyway, just in case. And that's it. That was really fun. All right. Need to get some little bags for all these bits. Okay, well, thanks for joining me, and I will see you next time. Ciao.